A question I get quite frequently from new streamers is why use multiple scenes in OBS Studio? Why not just throw everything into one scene and switch sources on and off from there? This video is going to be a bit more of a wrinkly brain five-head discussion on how to maximize OBS Studio. I'm Dwayne Berg, here to help make OBS less scary and more fun. And welcome back to my tutorial course. The entire course is linked in the video description, and if your question isn't answered in this video, check there. If you don't already know what scenes and sources are, check the lesson right before this one. It is specifically about scenes and sources and what they are. My own Twitch scene collection has tons of scenes. A starting soon screen, a main webcam for just chatting, a desktop scene for gameplay and tutorials, and many others. So why do I use multiple scenes instead of packing everything into one? Well, there are a few reasons. A good stream has things configured in a way that is seamless and visually appealing, such as your stream alerts being sized correctly not to block too much of your stream, or your face cam in a small corner so you can be seen, but without blocking too much of your gameplay, and so on. If you try to pack everything into one scene, then things won't look right, and your stream is gonna look like a can of busted biscuits. Plus, you can't have both a full-size webcam view and a cropped small corner face cam in the same scene without using something called scene nesting, which will be covered in the next lesson. By setting up different sources with things sized out and set up appropriately in separate scenes, you can create a dynamic and visually pleasing stream. The professionalism and polish will be appreciated by your viewers. The same goes for switching scenes. Fiddling with your mouse to show and hide sources or move things around will feel clunky to an audience. The more polished your streaming experience can be for your viewers, the easier it will be to gain new followers and keep them around and engaged. If you do different kinds of recording with OBS Studio, setting up separate scenes can save you time too. A webcam scene with a full screen webcam view for vlogs or channel updates. A portrait layout for recording YouTube shorts or TikToks. A gameplay face cam scene for live sessions. A desktop scene for tutorials, and so on. That's it for this lesson. If this lesson was helpful for you, please do me a favor. Hit the like button, subscribe to the channel with notifications on for more OBS tutorials, and tell a friend. I'll see you next time, and as always, stream on.